Peters. Melanie is one of the founders of Best of Worthing, and she now runs Worthing Food and Drink website and PR. Melanie, how are you?
So long. Yes, thanks. Yeah, not too bad. Thanks. Day by day. Every day's different.
Now, you're self-isolated.
Yeah, I am. Yeah, 12 weeks. Yeah.
Is that because you want to or because you've been told to?
No, because I've been told to by my consultant in London. So, yeah, you know, it is what it is.
And how are you coping?
Yeah, not too bad. It's difficult. I'd only just got used to the non-socialising as it was. And I'd only just got used to not going to work. I mean, I do work from home a lot anyway. And I just got my head around that. And then obviously this happened. So, you know, it's shopping and walking the dog and, you know, doing bits and pieces like that. So I think it's going to take me a couple of weeks to adjust to now not being able to do that either.
Yeah,
not too bad. Good days, bad days in the day. Yeah, not too bad. Mark's home, so he's helping out with some bits and pieces. So just trying to keep myself busy.
Mark has been working.
Yeah, he's been working up until now, but obviously he does security for all the events, so they've all been cancelled. So we're just going to take a couple of weeks out, and then he's going to see what else is out there, and I shall just do what I can from home as and when my customers reopen again.
Excellent. Now, tell me about this, the food that you're dealing with at the moment and the help you're giving to the people of Worthing and Ada as well.
So the food and drink group was started a few years ago as a platform for people to ask for reviews and recommendations and for businesses to advertise. And the reason why it's unique is because it's only a positive platform. So if you have got a negative review or you don't like something, you can't put it on the group. So about 3 or 4 weeks ago, we had 4,000 members on the group, and now that's grown to nearly 9,000 people. So we've collated a list of everybody that's delivering and categorised it. So there's grocers, butchers, fishmongers. You've got the normal delivery, all the restaurants and everything else. But the main thing is to keep people connected, especially those that are self-isolating, so that they can get what they're looking for. But ultimately, which is even more important, is to support the local businesses, which obviously 99% of them had a premises before this, so they're now relying on delivery only for their only source of income.
Yeah. How are people surviving, certainly in the Worthing area?
Yeah,
business-wise, yeah.
Yeah, not too bad. Just waving, Jennifer. Yeah, not too bad. I mean, some of the businesses that I'm speaking to and that I'm dealing with are doing really, really well. I mean, if it's all right to mention a couple, Piglet's Pantry, they make all the pies for Brighton and Hove Football Stadium. So they've now had to create a whole new business overnight to do delivery. So you can have cream and savoury tea, cream teas delivered. I mean, they told me they've had about 600 orders. So they're doing really, really well. You've got people doing afternoon teas and cream teas. You've got lots of sweet companies out there. You've got lots of cake companies. So I think generally now there's a really good positive vibe and people are having to think outside the box and think, well, that's what we normally do, but there's probably not a call for that right now. So, you know, the Parsonage have started a delivery, Indigo, the Factory, people that have never used delivery before are now delivering.
Yeah. And what about the charges? I mean, are they having to charge more for the service?
Do you know what? I think it depends on who you use. So some of the platforms, so delivery charge a really high percentage commission. I know that Just Eat and Dinner for Go have put their commissions down to help people. So generally, the people that were already delivering know because their prices are in place. And generally, I think the people that are now delivering, their prices are pretty fair. They're affordable, you know, considering a lot of us don't have much of an income at the minute. But there's a lot of people out there that are doing really affordable stuff. And you might pay a small delivery charge, but you're still getting food at a reasonable cost.
Yeah, and a lot of people, of course, come Sunday lunches, aren't they, as well?
Yeah, come dine with me, I think it is, or come dine with you. One, come dine with me. They're delivering three-course Sunday lunches. You've got, anything out there. The butchers are all doing barbecue packs. You've got people selling all different types of seafood, different grocery. Two of the companies, Giuseppe's Light and Adam Broderick, for all come dine with me, they've now created a new business as well. So they've now got a grocery business each. So they're selling all your groceries that you can get as well.
Yeah. Is this purely in Worthing or is it include Ada?
We generally, the group used to be just for Worthing and surrounding areas, but we've completely opened it up now. So we've got people from Chichester to Brighton not too many from Brighton, but they're ones that can deliver to Worthing. So there's quite a few Lance's businesses in there, Shoreham and Southwick. And from looking at what the businesses are doing, they're pretty flexible on delivery as well. So people can ask for a recommendation on the group. So somebody yesterday asked if they wanted some cakes delivered to their family in Littlehampton, and the woman said that she would do it. So no, the group spread. It's just obviously called the Worthing Food and Drink Group.
Yeah. In your feedback you're getting at the moment, are these businesses going to survive at the end of this period?
I don't know, to be honest with you. That's a good question. I mean, I don't know. Some of them, I don't like to say some of them no, because I wouldn't want that for them. But I don't know. Looking at some of the businesses now and how well they are doing on delivery and how perhaps they weren't that popular when the business was open, I think there's a whole new business for them this way. But are people's spending going to change when we get back to normal? Are people going to go back to maybe using the big shops that they wouldn't use before because they're not self-isolating anymore? So I don't really know. I mean, I'd like to think that these businesses would get all the support that they have been given everyone else, and all of us start realising that we need to support the independents more.
Yeah, I mean, if that brings me back to what I was going to say originally, of course, you started off with this very much best of Worthing and supporting local business. Yeah. I mean, how important is local business?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I'm a local business myself at the end of the day. I mean, if we don't spend money locally, then there are no local businesses. And we all need to be making sure that if we're spending locally and we're shopping locally, then these businesses are going to survive. You know, and isn't it? Ultimately, I'm sure every single one of us use probably one of the supermarkets, but even, I mean, I do support a lot of the businesses anyway, but my spending habits have changed and I am doing more now because I am at home and I'm using the independents for that. I would rather,
Are you getting like me and sort of putting too much weight on?
Yeah, definitely. I'm eating and drinking like it's Christmas Day every day.
That's been a bit like that, doesn't it? Yes. It's a shame. Melanie, I wish you the best. How do people actually find you?
The Worthing Food and Drink Group is on Facebook. You can join the group. All you need to do is adhere to the group rules that you'll keep everything positive. I've got my own social media, which is Rocket Social Media and Marketing. People can message me on there. And obviously I'm on Facebook as well, LinkedIn and Instagram. We've got I Love Sunny Worthing, where businesses can advertise on there at the minute. And we're not charging for that either right now. And that's normally a paid for platform, so people can advertise on there for free.
Excellent. Melanie, I wish you well. Thank you so much for your time today.
Take care.
And stay safe. Thanks very much.
See you later. Bye.